Hey guys, I wanted to do a short video emphasizing this one point of reading labels. Always read labels. One of my staff members recently asked me if it was okay to consume this peanut butter, okay? So I want to talk about this. And so first of all, it's called cookie butter, okay? So they thought it was peanut butter. And the first thing, if you open this up and smell it, it smells really good, like graham crackers, okay? And apparently it tastes really good because it's almost empty. Okay, and they wondered, why is this so addicting? It's like crack. They're like consuming the whole thing and putting it on all sorts of things and they can't stop eating it, right? So we looked at the label and it has 13 servings, but one serving is 2 tablespoons and the sugar grams is 11 grams. So if we take 11 grams times 13, I think that's over 100 grams of sugar. So this thing is a tremendous amount of sugar. Now, if we look at the actual label, it says the first thing is wheat flour. Yeah, so they thought they were getting peanut butter. Wheat flour? Okay, so that is a massively high glycemic index, and it's probably not even whole wheat, so not that it makes a difference. Okay, the next one is sugar. Vegetable oils containing, and this is interesting, one or more of soybean oil, safflower oil, canola oil, palm oil. Well, I will guarantee that they're probably not going to use palm oil or safflower oil. They're going to use soy oil. Why? Because it's cheap. But the problem is that's GMO. So they're consuming a really inflammatory type of oil. Next one is soy flour. Again, GMO because it's soy. Doesn't say organic. Then we got brown sugar, which is really the same as sugar with a little bit of molasses. And then we have sodium bicarbonate, salt, cinnamon, canola oil, sugar, soy lecithin, citric acid. Okay, so there's no peanut butter in here. There's no peanuts in here. So it's pretty much a highly addictive thing that you want to avoid if you're trying to lose weight. So again, if you see something new, read the label. And avoid it if it has all these bad foods. So my question to my staff was, what made you think that you could actually eat this? Did you read the label? And they did, but they pretty much were confused because they said, well, it didn't have maltodextrin, it didn't have dextrose, okay, it didn't say MSG, and also the sugar wasn't the first ingredient, but that really doesn't matter. Okay, so you have to read the whole label, and if it has that many things in it that you should avoid, just avoid it. All right? Thanks for watching. Hey, if you're interested in finding out the underlying cause of your body issues, click the link below and take the evaluation quiz.